1, 2, 3, 4.
In this tutorial, we'll be talking about the weld joint. This is a new type of joint introduced in Newton 4. It's a bit like a pivot joint, except that in this case, we're also introducing a certain form of tension and rigidity that will enable us to create some very interesting new animations. For example, here I've got four little squares and I'm going to use weld joints to join them together. So I'm going to launch Newton. I have set up a little keyboard shortcut. The F5 key on my keyboard launches Newton, or go to the composition menu and select Newton 4. So here I'm going to select them. Then, by pressing the Alt and Shift keys, I can create a series of recursive joints that go around my objects. So here I have four joints. For this example, I'm going to click on Collide Connected. This will allow objects that are connected to each other to interact. I'm going to increase my gravity a little. I'll also add a little sub-steps. I'm going to add a bit of bounciness to it. And there's also a little floor missing here. So I've got an object that's been welded with different joints, whereas here I've got several different objects. I'm also going to add a little angular velocity. So you can see that here I have a single object, and what I'm going to do is to use my weld joint so that on impact my object separates into several pieces. So maybe we'll try it here at frame 16. So I'm going to select all my joints, and then I'm going to deactivate my joint here at frame 16. And there you see that from a single object, I now have several objects. I could also do this is perhaps at a slightly more distant frame. Maybe frame 25, I don't know what it'll do. You can see that the object stays grouped for longer. We can render that 120 frames. It created a new composition called Sim1. And like this, I can see the result. Let's look at another example.
1, 2, 3, 4.
An example that is quite telling of how to use the options of this weld joint. Here I have an object and I've represented a swimming pool with a diving board. And I simply want my object to bounce off the diving board. So I'm going to run Newton. And I'm going to set up my scene. So this is all going to be static. And these two objects here, the board of my diving board is in two parts, and I'm going to link them with a weld joint. Now I'm going to move the anchor point with the Y key or by clicking on the icon here. I can also press the Command key at the same time, which will allow me to snap on my objects. And then we'll see what happens. I increase gravity and substeps. You can see it's welded, but I want there to be flexion, I want there to be dynamism, I want there to be rebound. So I'm going to use my weld joint, and I have a tension parameter here. I'm going to increase it a little. When it's zero, tension is automatic. In other words, it shouldn't move. I'm going to increase it a little. You can see that my joint acts as if it were a pivot. You can see that it rotates in relation to this axis. So I'm going to gradually increase the tension. You can already see that the result is a little different. So it's starting to get interesting. Now, for it to really bounce, I need to take my object and increase its density. That way, it'll be heavier. And now I've got something that's starting to look interesting, so I'm going to continue to build up this tension a little. Right now, it's not bad. And then I can also play with the damping. Maybe we'll see what happens afterwards. I'm going to increase my friction here, and then I'll move my object a little. Give it a little initial velocity so that I get a bell-shaped movement. I'm also going to give it a little angular velocity. I have my bounce effect thanks to the simulation of this diving board. We could also go a step further and use the water-like option in our simulation. We'll have to multiply the density a little, but I don't think that'll be enough. Maybe we'll go up to 18. I like it when there's 0-1 and 0-1 here. It usually works better. We've got something a little more liquid. Let's render this simulation and see what it looks like in After Effects. We'll open the new composition, which should be here. My water should be on top. I'll set it to color. And we'll do a little preview. One of the interesting uses of the weld joint is to animate the puppets. Here, for example, I want to animate my plant dynamically. This is an image. If I take it, you can see that there's transparency. I could create a mesh here and then animate it dynamically. The problem is that you have to link the mesh with Newton, but Newton doesn't take meshes into account. It does, however, take objects into account. What we're going to do is to use a tool provided with Newton 4 called PuppetMeshtoSolids. This tool will automatically create connected circles that will be placed on top of your puppet's pins and will link the transformation properties of these circles to your pins. This way, you can run simulations. These circles will move and influence the mesh. So how does it work? First of all, we're going to create a mesh quickly. Once we've got our meshes, I'm going to use my tool. I'm going to select my meshes, and then I'm going to press execute. And then it creates circles, which are my markers. And if I move these markers here, it moves my mesh. So I'm going to hide my plant because I don't need it. I'll show everything and hide my plant. My pot has a little problem. The anchor point is too high. So I'm going to lower it, put it in the middle, and that's it. And now I'm going to launch Newton. I'll start by taking this object here, and I'll set it to dead so that it doesn't influence my simulation for the moment. And then I'm going to hide it by pressing Alt-H. I'll press C to select by color and create my joints. I can also do it by hand. The yellow and the blue. That's my plant. I'll select these objects and set them to static. I'm going to increase the gravity a little more sub-steps, and then we'll see what happens. You have to imagine that my branches are going to move dynamically since they're linked together by weld joints. I'm going to connect my plants to my pot. To do this, I'll switch my roots to dynamic. I'm going to display my pot again. I'll also switch my pot to dynamic, and then I'm going to select each root of my plants. I'm going to link them with a weld joint to my pot. I press preview, and I've got the pot and plant linked together. All I need now is to send this ball to my pot. I'll give it a little push. I'll give it a little more density. And then I want to make sure that these elements don't collide with each other. So I'm going to remove group A. Now, if I run the simulation, I do have my plant moving. I'll render it. We'll see what it looks like in After Effects. So now that I've got that, I just need to display my plant. Hide the rest and do a preview. And here's my result. I've got my plant animated dynamically, attached to my pot and moving because of the collision with the ball. That's one version, but you could easily make a second. All we have to do is open our original scene, relaunch Newton, and then maybe we can take all these joints and modify them by hand. We'll add tension and damping. This will create a new scene, a new behavior. And then we can compare it with our previous scene. So, for example, we have this version here. We'll also render it. So I have this result, which is different from the other one. There's a little more flexibility because there was more damping. We've seen that thanks to the tool here called PuppetMeshtoSolids, we can link the Puppet tool to graphics and animate images, vectors, etc. with Newton.
I'll 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'll also show you the difference between a weld joint and a pivot joint. I think it's quite interesting, especially when it comes to creating strings or objects that are similar to this kind of thing. And we're really going to have a real plus there. So I'm going to launch Newton. And I'll start by selecting my objects by label. In green are the weld joints. I'll just add a pivot joint. And the blue will be the pivot joints. So I'm going to increase the gravity, and then I'm going to increase my substeps. I'm going to remove the collisions so that there's no interaction between the green group and the blue group. Let's see what happens. We can see that for the moment, there's a great deal of rigidity in the green group, which is the one with the weld joints, and much more freedom in the blue group. We're going to take all the weld joints and then gradually increase the tension to see what happens. Initially, it's going to be very similar to what you'd get with pivot joint. But gradually, as it stiffens, it starts to look a little different. And above all, there's the damping option, which can be increased quite significantly and will end up with much less parasitic movement in the string. And I think we'll end up with things that are much more graphic and pleasing to the eye. You can already really see the difference between the two. We've got a blue rope that's got a lot more movement, a lot more little imperfections, whereas on the green, we have something that's more rigid and less animated. So I think this movement is pretty good. I'm going to render it. Then we'll use our in-house software, Connect Layers Pro, to see the result. Here's what you can see in the end. You can see that the green rope is much stiffer and more realistic. So much for an overview of this weld joint. I hope you've enjoyed it, and I suggest you go and see the other functions in the other tutorials you'll find linked.
1, 2, 3, 4.